Hi all, welcome to my channel. So today's session we will learn how we can load the data from XML file. Okay, in earlier sessions we have learned to load the data from many sources. Like we have learned how we can load the data from Excel, from flat file. Oh, sorry, let me delete this. Wait a second. Okay, so we have learned how we can load the data from Excel, flat file, OLEDB and from raw file. Okay, so now in the session we will learn how we can load the data from XML file with the help of XML source. For that we need a sample XML. So you can Google and you can find number of sample file XML files available in the net. So I have downloaded one XML file here, and this is the XML file. Let's open it and we'll see what the data we have in this XML file. Let me double click. Let's walk through this XML file and we'll see what kind of the data we have. Then we will create a SSIS package. Okay, it is going to open the XML in Visual Studio. So I don't want that. Okay, by default if you double click it will open the it will use your Visual Studio to load. So here you can see we have the book details. In the book table we have this author, title, general price, published date, description. So if you see in each of the node, I mean the book is the parent node and these are the child nodes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So six columns we can say we have here. Okay, and this is a very simple file. So we can load this the data which is available in this XML with the help of SSIS package. So go here. So for that you can open this XML file in any other editor as well. So you can open like using the Internet Explorer also. So there is a lot of options. So by default, because Visual Studio is open, so it has taken the Visual Studio platform to open this. So let me take on the Internet Explorer and we'll see the XML file there. Let's wait for a couple of seconds. Yeah, here we go. So it is giving a better vision. Okay, so if you see here, click on close this book ID. Okay, author, title, general price, published date, description. So book ID 1, book ID this 2, 3, 4. So this is the format of our XML file. So this is fine. Close this. Now we go ahead and create a SSIS package. We have already one package here, package 1. So let me rename it and we'll rename it as the load XML data. Okay, XML file data. We are going to load the XML file data to the SQL Server table. So for that we need to first, as we know already, we need to use the data flow task. And for this session, what would be our source? It would be XML source. So double click here and drag it to the center. Double click to open the editor. So configuration, here we see the data access mode. So if you have a location of the files, you can use it. If you have your XML file placed in some kind of variable, then you can use this option. For this session, we'll keep this thing because we have the location where the XML file is present. So we need to provide the location. Browse, go here, and I have chosen my file. Now it is asking use inline schema. Some of the case, if you have a schema already in their XML, then you need to check this. Okay, you need to select this. And just in case, if you will not provide it the SST. SST is actually the schema of the XML which tells the definition, the description of the XML. Like XST says that what this XML is all about. This XML is like of which version. Okay, this XML is containing which, what kind of the data it is containing. So the metadata, we can say the metadata of the XML is available in XST. So when I downloaded this from the internet, I did not get the XST. So there is an option, you can generate the XST as well. So you can click there. And it is asking me in which location do you want to create the XST. So I have by default it is chosen the same location where our XML file is present. So I'm okay with it. Click on save. See XSD. The schema is with an extension XSD. XML is with an extension XML. So go here and check once. See, this is the XSD information. The main data is of 5 KB. Okay. And the information about the XML is of 2 KB. Okay. Now go here and click on columns. So it will give the some kind of the warning that all the columns is containing no maximum length was specified. So that is fine. We can ignore it. It is saying that all columns is taking the 255 will be used. So if you wanted to change, you can change it. It is just kind of warning that your memory, buffer memory will be unnecessarily utilized because of that. So click on OK. That is fine for us because it's a small project. Click on OK. So now our XML source is now configured. OK. Now we need to put this data or load this data into the data SQL server. So for that we have OLEDB destination connection manager, and drag here, connected, double click, and we already have this connection manager. So just in case if you do not know how to create it, there is a new button and you can configure it. In my previous sessions, you if you have followed my previous session, you will get to know. And just in case if you have no knowledge about it, then please check my previous session, you will get to know. To saving the time, I'm just doing it. Then name of the table. So as of now, in this database, I mean in this simple DB, I have employee data and employee data one table. I do not have a table corresponding to this XML. So there is a new button here. If you do not have a table and you wanted to create the table, okay, corresponding to the source data on runtime, okay, so there is a new button, you can do that thing as well. So click on new. So I wanted to create a new table. So by default it is saying create table OLEDB destination, but I'll make it as a book details, right? Make it, I wanted the table to be created with this name, book details. And so if you see here 255 255 255, so this is the warning what we are getting. So if we know, if we have checked the we have checked the XML file and we have found that ID is nothing is not more than a 5 character, so we can make it as a 10. Okay, here you can change the name, here you can change the length. Okay, so I'll make it as 100, and I'll keep all other columns as same. Click on OK. So new table will be created. If you click on view existing, so here it is saying that table schema has been created, structure has been created, but data is not loaded here. So view existing, there is no data. So that will be done once we execute it. So all the columns, because we are creating the table in one go, so in the runtime, so the columns would be definitely matched, the same column will be created in the definition. Click on OK. So it is saying the warning here, truncation may occur due to the inserting the data from the data flow column author. So it is saying that in a source, you have an author column with a 255 character, but you have changed your table and make it short as a 100. So maybe if in case, if you execute this package and if somebody, some author is having more than 100 character name, then you get an error. The truncation may occur. So that kind of the error we are, a warning we are getting. So that is fine, we can ignore it. Now I'll go here and execute the package and just wait for a couple of seconds, and we'll see the new table will be created and we will get the data also in the table. So as of now, I do not have a table in the SQL Server database which I have chosen. Okay, so we have 12 rows inserted into the OLEDB destination table. So let's go here and check it. As you see here, sample DB is the database. Okay, we have only those two tables. Let me select this table and refresh the tables here. And then we will see we have a new table, book details, which is created by the SSIS package. Okay, now open a new query and see what the data we have in this table. Did we get all the 12 records? So let's check here. Click on execute. See, we got the 12 records here. Okay, we got the 12 records. So this way you can load your XML data as well with the help of SSIS package to the SQL Server table. And in case if you do not have a table already created in the table in the SQL Server, then you can create a table in on runtime as well with the help of SSIS package in Dataflow task. So guys, I think you like the video. Thank you and have a nice day.